got a custom reverse access pipe to make, and I know I made that on my last live, but they're just so fucking cool. I'm gonna do it again. I absolutely love them. Oh, and I did the giveaway of that black and white reverse access pipe that I made last time for the 1,000 followers. So go check out the last live video. I gave that pipe away. So I've got this prepped up. I'll show you. Let me flash it first. So it's like a rainbow and then sparkles. I wig-wagged it. So basically I took a section, spun it one way, took the next section, spun it the other way. What I mean by that is spin it faster with one hand and then spin it faster with the other hand. Did that all the way down, wig-wagged it. All right, I made it. Hey, you made it. Good job. So I'm gonna shrink this down into a bubble and then I'm gonna reverse access it. Till this cools down, pop a hole center somewhere that I can connect a new handle to, and I'm gonna make it from flowing all this way to flowing this way. So the handle will be coming in on one of these sides. Reverse access. Freaking love this color too. Feel free to ask me any questions. I'll just answer them as I go. So first I'm going to get the spot hot and kind of blow like a mountain where the hole is going to be. out a little bit, and then I'll pop it open. And I'm gonna flash this. Whenever I say flash, I just mean give it more heat. And then I've got a handle in my annealer that is sitting at 1100 degrees. And I'm gonna attach this to that bowl I just made. So everything is going this way now. Rad colors. Thank you. I absolutely love my custom spoon, pipe, messing ornament, and chill. Fuck yeah. I'm happy you're happy. I just want to make people happy. I got the handle off, now I just want to pick off anything I don't want on the end. There's some clear left on there, I don't want that. Round again. So here's what we got so far. Now I got like this little bird thing going on. I want to get rid of that triangle. So I'm just going to get the whole thing really hot, round it back out, and then I can start shaping it into a pipe. And I'm leaning it down so everything gets a little longer. It's very stout right now. I need it longer to make the pipe. Made it more round, but still got a little triangle I gotta get rid of. One more heat, and then it'll be gone. There's a tiny dot left, we can work with that. I don't know who he is, but there's a little bulge left. That's okay. I'm gonna start shaping the pipe. Could you tell me why when I focus my flame in certain spots, say to make a weld, it'll make the glass hazy looking and I can't, because you burn it. Don't burn the glass. Just do a softer flame, maybe the flame further away. Yeah, once you burn it, you can't go back. So, softer flame. And if that just means heating it up for longer. That's better than using too hot of a flame and burning it. So heat it up slower. Alright, it's a little off center, so I'm going to heat that handle. Woo! And then fucking heat it up. I just wanted it to fall a little bit more. We almost lost it. Good thing I've got fucking cat-like reflexes. I'm gonna attach a new handle. This is really fucking short though. Oh well, that's what we're doing. I just kind of tapered that down. Too hot, yeah. Focus on the middle of the pipe, so like the long shaft part. So I'm just going to blast the very center and pull her apart where the mouthpiece and the end is going to be. I also need to melt in that little bulge I got going, so I'm going to kind of focus on that as well. Ooh, it's fucking hot. It's so hot. You can see the middle of the piece starting to form. Plug my heater quick. It's like 75 fucking degrees. When I started, it was like 65. Okay, now we're good. So I've got the center separated. I know it looks wonky. It's gonna look fucking beautiful when I'm done. Don't worry. It's reverse axis, so it looks kind of fucked up. I'm gonna do the mouthpiece right here, right now.
Right here.
I was just flashing that bowl part because I'm going to work on that in a few minutes and I don't want it to get cold. So I'm just pulling out a thick part to the mouthpiece. Trying to keep it centered. It's not easy. And then I'm going to round out the mouthpiece. So right above where it's hot, right there, I'm going to round all that out. Ooh, I got an order. Just going to flash the bowl again, get some heat back in there. And round out the mouthpiece. Getting the glass really round on these reverse access pieces is so much more difficult than just a regular access pipe because the colors are twisted all fucking funny. Got a round mouthpiece. Alright. Mucho better. Now I'm gonna round out the bowl part. If you get your punchy right, it should fall off and not have any color on the end. Or leave a mark here. It left a little mark, but not too bad. I don't need a handle anymore. My oxygen is running low. That's okay. We're almost done doing the melty. I won't need a big flame too much longer. So this is really cool. Watch how wonky this goes from to how round. once I get it hot enough. You can see how wonky that is. It's a pretty freaking round. Glass just wants to be round. Not too shabby. That's what I figured, but thanks. Yeah, burning the glass is no fun. So I'm just going to spin it and look at where I want the front to be, or in other words, where I'm going to pop the hole and push the hole. I think like, it's either right there, I'm thinking, or right there, probably right there. Yeah, let's do that. That's fucking cool. So I'm just gonna blast a spot where the bowl hole is gonna be. Ooh, kind of got a piece. I'm gonna puff it up. And now I know where I wanna pop it when it's sideways in the flame. Now that I have a hole, I'm just gonna blast the flame and circle around it. And then I'll touch the bowl. And I want to be switching hands when I do this so it stays even because it's liquid when it's molten. And here's my bowl push. It's just graphite with like a rubber handle. I'm going to give it one puff before I push it just to kind of solidify the size of that bowl hole. I don't want it to shrink or get bigger when I push it. It shrunk, so I had to blow it. I'm gonna circle around it a couple more times, and then I'll push it. Push it. That's a good push. I will flatten the bottom next. I'm just going to blast out any diversification or weird marks I might have gotten from that bowl push. Also, the hole is a little bit larger than I want it to be, so I can shrink it down just by blasting the flame into it. And switch sides because that hole, it's going to move the whole bowl because you're getting it so hot. And then I just round it out again. Got too hot. There it is. And then I've got a light up here that I kind of like to shine through. See if I have any weird lines or anything. So flatten the bottom next. Now the most important part about flattening the bottom is make sure the mouthpiece is hitting, not any globs that are down here, because this is what's going to be sitting together after you're done with the bowl. So make sure this is hitting and then smush that. And then I'll put a choke on the, he wants it on the right side. Or she, I'm not sure actually. So right side choke. I'm going to do the same thing I did with the little mountain. I'm going to get a spot hot, clog the bowl hole, and blow a little mountain. That's a weird sentence. I got a little mountain where the choke is gonna be. I'm just gonna get a fluffy flame and pop it out. Pop it out. And then I'm just gonna make it round, flat, and round, and flat. Do that as many times as you need. I don't know if everybody does that, but I've got OCD, so there's that. There's a little bit of haziness. I don't know if you can see that, like right there. I can just blast that out in the flame once I heat it up again. It'll just disappear. So it's not burnt. It just moved when it was a little too cold to move. So I'm gonna pop this in my annealer. It's sitting at 1100 degrees. Oh, those colors are popping. That's so pretty. I'll show you what I'm working on too really quick because I got to pee. Working on cookie. I just got to finish the head. That's a custom order. These are always available on my website, made to order. So, thank you for watching. I'll do another giveaway at 2,000 subscribers. I think it's going to happen sooner than later. So, thanks again for all the love, all the support. I'll see you soon.